Hello, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com with excellent news for you today that scientists are starting to see some experimental physics results showing that there may be no such thing as one objective reality. This is the work of some teams of scientists that are studying at the University of Edinburgh called, this is Heriot-Watt University, and also in conjunction with scientists at Kaslov-Bruckner at the University, that's the name of the scientist, Kaslov-Bruckner at the University of Vienna. The team leader over in Edinburgh is Massimiliano Proietti. And so the work of these teams of physicists are showing that essentially the idea that when we make an observation in quantum physics, you might already know, or maybe you don't know, that to make a very clear measurement, or an observation as a scientist would call it, is to witness that quantum photon, for example, something that cannot be collapsed any further, that's what makes it quantum. A photon is about the smallest it can get. It doesn't go smaller. And when you take a look at that and observe it, you can either see that it's showing up like a particle. So if it goes through the double slit experiment, then it's going through like a little ball, like a paintball, leaving a splat on the screen, versus if they observe, the scientist is observing and notices it's going through like a wave, so it's leaving little ripples like you'd see if you threw a pebble in a pond. And those are the two types of results you get when you make the observation. And if you haven't yet observed anything, then there's what's called the superposition of states, where there's no collapse of any wave functions, so there's no measurement possible. It's just in that blur. The experiment that's been conducted now started out as a thought experiment, Gedankenexperiment, and this is something that goes way back. You might recall Schrödinger's cat, when Erwin Schrödinger had the idea to put a hypothetical cat inside of a box that is airtight with a vial of poison, which is triggered by a little device, radioactive device with radioactive isotope, which decays at some random rate, and then at some moment it may or may not kill the cat when the trigger breaks the vial and the poison's released. This seemed ridiculous to Erwin Schrödinger that a cat could exist in a superposition of states. How could that be? So just trying to make it into something we could wrap our minds around. What's really interesting is, in addition to Erwin Schrödinger's hypothetical experiment with the cat, Eugene Wigner, another scientist, said, what if another scientist also observes? Might that result in two different observations? This has been a question that has not been answerable because not until recently has an experimental protocol involving, in this case, beam splitters, lasers, and several different little observation points acting as the observers with six different photons been able to replicate this Gedanken experiment. What the experimenters are finding is that when one observer is watching, that scientist can take a measurement and determine whether the photon is either particle or acting like a wave. A second observer doesn't necessarily know that the first observer has observed anything at that moment, but might be aware that there is no observation yet made. In other words, that there's still a superposition of states existing. So that would then give us this result, which was in this case, to me, it feels like the shot heard around the world. This is big news to me, that for the first time we're getting the initial results from some quantum physics experiments that show that there may not be just one objective reality. So when we look at the way nature operates, this is not such a big surprise. We can see evidence with photosynthesis. We can see evidence with instantaneous types of evolutionary leaps made by bacteria that are put in a lactose-based nutrient agar solution, for example. They're capable of mutating, evolving to a new state of organism that can digest that lactose within one generation. And these sorts of things are philosophically described as being possible and expected by such philosophers as Nicholas Rescher, who wrote a book called Axiogenesis, which I highly recommend. So anyway, going back to the results from these experiments, the big news is that thanks to this big rush, the gold age of quantum computing is on, we will now be seeing increasing degrees of quantum principles and philosophies and quantum phenomena occurring on a macroscopic scale, like the entangled diamonds that we've already seen that you can hold in your hand and look at, and they can move together just like a part of a quantum computing device. So we're seeing a lot of things that are happening just in our lifetime now. And for me, it's personally validating to get this kind of news, because for 20 years I've dedicated my life's research to studying firsthand reports of people saying that they've witnessed a shift in reality, that they've seen perhaps a Mandela effect where a whole bunch of people are noticing that things are not the way that the official history describes, they remember it differently. And thanks to the internet, we can share these experiences now. And thanks to experiments like this one, we're starting to see that's okay. This might be the way the universe works. Instead of a consensus reality where everything always agrees and that's the root truth, it looks like things could be quite a bit more subjective and based on our observer status, which means that when we ask a question like the one I love to ask, how good can it get, we can perhaps transform seemingly impossible situations and make our way through insurmountable seeming problems. So if you'd like to read the details about this experiment, please click the link at the bottom of this video, because then you can go to read a little bit more about what I wrote as a blog, click through to the link and learn a lot more. Until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, reminding you to keep asking my favorite question, how good can it get? Thanks so much.